Vsauce, Kevin here. Astronaut Mike Hopkins ran around the world.
Sort of.
During a 12-mile run on a treadmill, the space station had orbited the Earth and traveled more than 25,000 miles. What the FAK? The facts and knowledge on the daily life of astronauts. With a new sunrise every 90 minutes interrupting their natural circadian rhythms, along with loud engine noises and floating in microgravity, it's much harder to sleep in space than on Earth. Astronauts have to tether sleeping bags to the ground, ceiling, or wall so they don't float around and bump into things. Aboard the International Space Station, crew members have individual sleeping quarters that are well ventilated, so they're not surrounded by the carbon dioxide they're exhaling. Earplugs, sleep masks, and sleeping pills are used to combat the unusual feeling of sleeping without gravity. Yet, astronauts still get 30 to 60 minutes less sleep per night on average compared to when they're on Earth. Since water won't naturally fall into a drain system, astronauts get creative when it comes to showering. Like taking a sponge bath where they moisten a cloth using warm packaged water with soap already mixed in, rubbing themselves down and drying off with a towel. Sometimes they can shower in a plastic cylinder that goes from floor to ceiling to prevent water from floating away. For their hair, there's a rinseless shampoo that is applied, rubbed in, and wiped off with a towel. Because there's no washer or dryer, clothes are disposable. Shirts, socks, and underwear are changed every day or two, and pants once a week. That's just inside the stabilized interior. If they're required to go out into space, it gets a lot more complicated. Spacesuits must protect from a pressurized atmosphere, provide oxygen, allow sight and movement, protect from radiation and micrometeoroids, and do all of this while keeping the human body at a comfortable temperature. There are 25 steps to take when getting into and out of the 13-layer, 280-pound, $12 million suit, referred to as an EMU. Astronauts select their food menus about 5 months before taking flight. Those selections are sent in for review and analyzed for nutritional content because nutrition is vital to the health of the crew. Each is provided with 3 meals a day plus snacks, with 2 days worth of emergency meals per person if needed. Aboard the shuttles at the ISS, foods come prepared in 4 ways. Thermostabilized, rehydratable, natural form, and irradiated. They're stored in special packaging to prevent anything from floating around, and even condiments like salt and pepper are suspended in liquid to prevent particles from floating away. For exercise, there's a treadmill, stationary bike, or resistance training. 2.5 hours a day are devoted to physical fitness. One reason this is so important is because astronauts lose plasma throughout the body because body fluids move around in microgravity. And exercise is proven to increase the amount of plasma. When they're not working out or walking in space, they stay entertained by watching TV streamed from Earth, working on the computer, and reading, along with doing experiments on how things work in microgravity. Toilets are equipped with footholds, and both men and women can urinate standing up with the aid of a funnel. When it's time to sit down, astronauts pull a bar over their laps like when riding a roller coaster that fastens to their thighs. To avoid anything floating around, space toilets use flowing air instead of water to flush. When astronauts return from spacewalks and remove their helmets, there's a lingering odor of what space smells like left on their suits, and it's described to be similar to burnt metal. I'm gonna leave you with this. Who's the only US president to ever be present during the launch of a shuttle? Before we go, here's last video's winner. Leave your answers in the comments below, be sure to subscribe for more Vsauce 2, and as always, thanks for watching.
And that's just by surface tension. And then you can drink it.